All right, team. Happy Monday. Welcome to Quick Fixx. My name is Lynne. I will be taking you through your 30-ish minute workout. Most of the workout today is body weight, so we don't need a lot of equipment. We will use weights for swings. So suitcase swings, whether they're at your side, hinge forward, stand up tall. And then maybe for some lateral lunges if you choose. If you'd like to have a mat nearby, you can grab one of those. Welcome, virtual crew. We're excited to have you here. I am recording this for later use, so it looks like it's time for us to go ahead and get started. Setting up, let's go ahead and start in our squat stance. Feet about shoulder distance. We're gonna set the hips back, bending the knees, keeping the toes and heels glued to the floor, ensuring that our knees and toes are headed the same direction. Looking good in-house, keep going. I'm gonna add some music to our session here. Exhaling your way to the top. Couple more here. And after your next one, let's go eyes wide, T. Setting the feet up right underneath the hips. Let's hinge forward, long arms, bringing the arms up by the ears, then opening up, and then hands right in line with the shoulders. So you've got your I, your Y, and your T. Keeping the belly button pulled in tight, chest pointed more towards the floor. One more full cycle here. And then we'll return to standing, taking hands behind the ears for your good morning, getting set up for those swings, reaching back with the tailbone, long spine, and then stand up tall, stacking shoulders on hips, feeling a stretch through the hamstrings as you hinge forward, pinching the shoulder blades together on the backside to keep the chest wide. Nice job, keeping eyes forward of the feet as you reach back with the hips. Two more here. And let's transition to lunges. Going reverse lunge, stepping back, bending the back knee towards the floor, keeping the knee stacked over the ankle on the lead leg. If you find that this challenges your balance today, maybe go a little bit wider with your step. So thinking feet more like on train tracks versus a balance beam. Keeping the trunk tall. So I don't know if all of you heard this, but we're not gonna get a lot of rest today once we get into the workout. However, with that being said, it is always on you to take rest when you need it. Catch up when you're ready, especially if you need rest that I'm not giving you. Get a couple more here. And then we'll go into our hand walkouts, one more to each side. And switch your hand walkouts. We'll hinge at the hips. Walk the hands out to a high plank. Take that into a push-up. You can go from the knees if you need to here early on. And walk hands back to the feet. Stand up tall, stacking shoulders on hips. And let's go again. Keeping the core tight as you lower the body. Exhale up. We should probably do two more. As you perform your push-up, elbows drive back so they point more towards the hips versus out to the side. I tell you that because we're gonna do some push-ups later in the workout. After you finish your last one, let's take an extra wide stance and go bootstrappers. Toes will point out slightly. Let's hinge at the hips, grab the feet, then drop the hips low, elbows inside the knees. Ensuring that your heels are on the floor, go ahead and exhale the hips high. If you find that your heels have left the floor, go ahead and take a wider stance so you can keep them glued to the floor. Continue to work through a hamstring stretch with hips high and a hip opener with hips low. At your own pace. Then we'll move into a best stretch. So plant the hands, walk the feet back to high plank. So hands are under the shoulders, feet are about hip distance. Let's go ahead and bring the right foot forward. right outside the right hand, or as close as you can get there. Open the hip by pressing the elbow into the side of the knee. And then rotate towards the lead leg with the intention of stacking shoulders. Then bring both hands down back to the floor. Press the floor away as you send the hips high for a hamstring stretch right through that lead leg. And let's take it to left side, high plank, left foot forward. Open the hip, add rotation, plant the hands, send the hips high for your hamstring stretch. Back to high plank, let's do it one more time on each side. Right foot forward, open the hip, add rotation, plant the hands for your hamstring stretch. And then last one, left side. Foot forward, open the hip, add rotation, plant the hands, hamstring stretch, return to high plank, walk the hands back to feet. Then let's return to that extra wide stance, even wider this time. We're going to shift the hips back by bending one knee, alternating sides. Looking good. Toes stay pointed forward of the hips. Good adjustments. Sending the hips back so that the bent knee stays behind the toe. One more each side, then we'll go through another series of walkouts. Planting the hands. This time, maybe picking up the speed, walking out. Push up, hands back to feet. Stand up tall. Let's go again. A little more speed this time. Might look different for all of you, and that's okay. Let's get two more here. Last one. And then grab some water as we talk about the next part of our workout. This is the rest part, so take full advantage. This is your rest for the workout. We have four rounds. We're going to work for 30 seconds. You get 15 seconds of rest in between. We have five exercises. You get a little bit longer rest between your, yeah, now you guys want water, got it. 30 seconds to work, 15 seconds in between exercises. Each time we see this, I'll give you some different options. Our first one's gonna be kind of practice. First exercise, squats. We're just gonna start there. You can keep them body weight because we're gonna continue to get progressive options in each round. Getting set up, we go in 5, 2, 1, here we go. So you can pick up the speed here. If that serves you, if you still are in warm-up mode, that's all right. Just like we talked about in the warm-up, heels glued to the floor, toes gripping the floor, sit the hips back. You got about 10 more seconds here, then you'll rest for 15 seconds, and we'll move into our suitcase swings. 2, 1, that's a wrap. Suitcase swings. Will be weights at the sides, reaching back, flat back, and standing up tall with power. We go in 5. And go. Flat back with power. Stack the shoulders right on top of the hips. Looking good, team. As the hips go back, the belly button pulls in. Excellent work in-house. The arms just float forward. You're not actually lifting the weights up. Great job, team. A couple more swings. And time. Next one up, we see blast off push-ups. And actually, let's start with push-ups in the first round. We'll add blast off later. 2, 1, here we go. Just like we talked about in the warm-up, elbows drive back towards the hips, exhale your way to the top. Core stays tight, glutes are engaged, quads are engaged. 10 seconds here. Exhale up, doing great. two, one, time. Nice job. Next one up, lateral lunges. This time we'll step our lunges. So we'll step out to the side, shift the hips back. Going in five, two, one, let's go. So hips shift back, toes pointed forward of the hips. You got stretch to the inner thigh, working the outside of the hip. Two, one, time. One more and then we're done with the first round. Next one up, mountain climbers for 15 seconds, high knees for 15 seconds. Get set up. Two, one, here we go. High plank, drive the knees in towards the chest. 10 more seconds here, then we'll pop up and go high knees, unless you want to stay in your mountain climber. In 5 seconds, we switch. Pull the belly button in. Two, one, come up, high knees. 10 seconds here, team. Official rest on the other side. Two, one, recover. Nice job. All right. So the next round, I'm gonna give you some alternatives or some suggestions to make it a little bit more challenging. If that was challenging enough, stick with what we just did. In your first one, rather than just squats, we're gonna go full squat, half squat, all the way down, all the way up. So it's one and a half. So down, part way up, all the way down, all the way up. Swings will stay the same. Push-ups can stay the same, or you can do blast off. So you'll bend the knees, hips to heels, and then go into your push-up. Let's start there. We go in 20 seconds. How many rounds down? One. So that's where I usually lose track after the first one. So I'm putting that on you guys. 5 seconds, here we go. One and a half reps. Two, one. Here we go, all the way down. Part way up, all the way down, all the way up. If you don't like it, go back to the squats. We're holding a little bit more time under tension. Pressing the knees wide so that they stay in line with the toes. Ten seconds here. Really nice work, team. Way to keep the heels down, keep the chest tall. Two, one, time. Next one up's your swings. First round looks excellent. I don't have to say too much about it other than keep up the good work. Let's get set. Two, one, here we go. Nice lat backs. Keep the core tight. Halfway. And tough. Two, one, time. Next one up. Blast off push-ups. Or use it as an opportunity to just practice your push-ups. 5 seconds. Two, one, let's go. Bend the knees, hips to heels, and into your push-up. Once you have the pattern down, you can pick up the speed. Halfway. Excellent form, team. Two, one, time. Awesome. Those are great. Next one up, lateral lunges. If you want to take it to a hop, you can. You'll lunge, hop over, lunge on the other side. Two, one, here we go. So either have your standard lunge or you can hop. Bring the heart rate up a little bit more. Halfway. 5 seconds here. Way to shift the hips back. Time. Next one up. Mountain climbers to high knees. Two, one, let's go. Pull the belly button in. Keep the shoulders stacked over the wrists. In 5 seconds, we switch. Two, one, switch. If high knees doesn't work, sprint in place. Whatever that means to you today. Let's go. Two, one, time. Two rounds down. How are you doing, team? I mean, you can stop whenever you want. It's your workout. Feels like enough. Next one. Take any of the options I've already given you. I'm gonna give you another squat option. This time, regular squat, then squat jump. Then regular squat, squat jump. You leave the floor, your landing's quiet. We have about 25 seconds. Everything else, same options. Until we get to the mountain climbers, I'll give you something else there. In 10. Three, two, one, round three. Squat, squat jump if you want it. Squat, squat jump, yeah. Nice quiet landings. So proud of you, team. We're halfway. Ten seconds here. Two, one, time. What's up next? Swings? Let's do swings next. Five seconds. Ready? Go. Heels and toes glued to the floor. Spine stays long. Squeeze the rib cage towards the spine. Keep the back tight. Nice job, team. Last five. Two, one, time. Blast off push-ups coming your way. Finding some power from that sit back. Going in five. Two, one, let's go. Core stays tight. Nice job. Hips are solid and strong. Exhale your way out of the push-up, let's go. Two, one, time. Lateral lunge is next. You wanna take a ribbon lunge if you know it, you can do that. Weight comes in front of the leg, up and over to the other side. I'll get caught in my microphone, so I'm gonna stick with the other ones. Two, one, let's go. Got it, nice job. Excellent work on the ribbon lunges. Halfway. Two, one, time. Mountain climbers, high knees, or burpees for a full 30. Marissa, come in with me. Two, One, let's go. Here's halfway. Switch. High knees. Five seconds. Two, one, rest. How are you doing? One more round. I wish you did too. I'll get choked up next time. 'll keep it the same. You've had a lot of options. Pick your favorite for your last round of this. What's that? Yeah, absolutely. Your workout, friend. 15 seconds. Then we'll see. Final set. Two, one, let's go. Take whichever variation you want for your final round. Halfway. Looking so good in-house. Nice work. Two, one, time. Swing's coming up. 10 seconds, then we're in. Get set. Two, one, let's go. Reach back with the weights, power to standing. Halfway. Last five. Two, one, time. Last off push-ups or push-ups coming in hot. Getting set, we go in five. Two, one, here we go. Keep the core solid and strong. Nice job. Way to keep the chin out of the chest. Looking strong and powerful here, team. Couple more, you got it. Two, one, time. Lunge options next. Ribbon, hopping, standard, all good. We go in five. Two, one, let's go. Nice job keeping toes pointed forward of the hips. Halfway. Two, one, time. Ten seconds. Then your cardio. You pick how you want to use it. Yep. Two, one, let's go. Yeah. 10 seconds, team. Go big here. Two, one, time. Hydrate. Awesome work. Catch your breath. How are you feeling? Short finisher coming up. So close. We'll do a little bit more. You're prepared for it. So you're still resting. The last one is going to be a leg for short finish. So it's going to be as many rounds as you can get on a clock. We're going to go reverse lunge, jump squat, plant the hands, push up from the knee if you need it. Okay. Does it look like a burpee? Kind of. 20 seconds. We run the clock 1 minute, as many as you can get. And that's going to be the end. I mean, I'll probably win, right? Or you're going to win. I got it. Oh, I'm following Marissa. All right, team. Two, one, 60 on the clock. Lunge, lunge, jump squat, plant the hands, push up, back up, lunge, lunge, jump squat, push up. Now you know the pattern. As fast as you can. In good form. You've built up to this. You've been practicing the last 25 minutes. Seconds to go. Keep working hard here. As far as you can. Two, one, time. Awesome work. Shake out the legs. So impressed and proud of you guys. Awesome work. We don't leave any formal time for stretching, but I will take you through some stretches. So if you can stay for them, please do. If you have to take off, just wipe down your equipment and have a lovely rest of your Monday. When you're ready to get into some stretches, let's start with the chest and release the fingers near the tailbone and open up the chest and the front of the shoulders. Pressing into the palms. Let's reverse that. Interlace the fingers out in front, flip the palms out, round out the upper back. Maybe tuck the chin, but keep the trunk tall. Relax the arms, let's go into the legs. Right leg, quad stretch. Heel to rear, hang on to it with one hand. Hang on to something if you need to, if you can get both hands to grasp on. That's an option as well. You look good in-house. Knees are close together, pressing the hips forward. Let's take that same leg, elevated leg out in front. Go into your hamstring stretch, plant the heel. Shift the hips back, keeping the spine long. Return to standing tall. Let's take that same leg, cross it over the thigh. Watch me balance. Sit the hips low into your figure four. Again, if you need to hang on to something, do that. And find a position that will give you some stretch through the hip, the glute region. Let's come out of that. Take it to side two. Where'd we start? Quad stretch. any of you are interested, it works in your schedule. Halftime starts tomorrow. Heather and I are co-teaching. It's 8 total classes. You can come to 1, you can come to 8, anything in between. It's a 50-minute class over the lunch hour. You can only stay for 30 minutes, that's okay too. Go ahead and take that leg out in front, hamstring stretch. It's gonna be 8 separate classes, so each class is gonna look a little bit different. All of them are gonna be a lot of fun. There's a virtual option available. Equipment might be a little bit different for the virtual crew on occasion, but we've got you covered. Let's go ahead and go figure 4. Sit the hips low. We've also reserved 2 studios for in-house, so if you're worried about getting a spot, there'll be space. Tuesdays, it's at 11. Thursdays, it's at noon. All available, or information is available on the website. Come up to standing tall. Let's go ahead and go frog squat. Wide stance, toes point out. Sit the hips low. Open the hips, pressing the elbows to the insides of the thighs. Plant the hands. Walk the feet in so that they're right underneath the hips. Keeping the knees bent, go ahead and lay the belly right on top of the thigh. Let the head hang heavy. Take some big breaths, filling the belly, lengthening the lumbar spine. And then go ahead and tuck the chin into the chest. And one vertebrae at a time, roll your way up to standing. Chin will come out last. Big inhale, arms up overhead. And exhale, arms come down. Excellent job. So good to see all your faces on a Monday. I will say bye to the virtual crew.
Thank you.
Of course.
Hi, Lynn. Thanks.
Good to have you.